Good day, everyone. J7409 here with your hurricane tropical update. Got lots to talk about. We're looking at Hector, Hurricane Hector, and this morning Hector is a category 4 hurricane. Still, it's a very strong storm with the winds, but it's still, so far as the size of Hector, is kind of a small hurricane. But it's packing the winds, a category 4 this morning. And then we have Tropical Storm Elena. That's right. Now, this is in the Pacific also. And Elena should probably intensify right on up. And who knows, by tomorrow, maybe be a full-fledged storm. Okay, she could be a hurricane by Tuesday, I think. This is Elena. And then we have Tropical Storm John. Yes, can you believe it, people? A category 4 hurricane, 2 tropical storms. One of them should be a hurricane by tomorrow, and John here will probably turn into one also, not too far behind. Now, here we go over to the Atlantic. This is Invest 97L. It's looking kind of puny, okay? I really don't think it's going to amount to a whole lot, but I think the track may change some from what it looked like yesterday. Instead of heading on over maybe around France or the areas over there across the pond, I think it may go a little more north. But we'll check everything out in this edition of The Tropical Update with J7409. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. Click the bell and make sure you get all the latest in the tropical information. We're going to start over in the Atlantic this morning. And here it is, right here, the disturbance, of course. And as you can see, it's looking like it may take a more northerly path. We'll get into this a little bit later on in more detail. But as of 2 a.m. this morning, it's still a non-tropical system, the surface low pressure system, is centered about 1,200 miles southeast of the Azores. It's interacting with a band of upper level low, and although the thunderstorm activity has increased near and to the east of the low level center, environmental conditions are expected to be only marginally conducive for the low to acquire subtropical or tropical characteristics while it moves little. It's just meandering around out there for the next day or so. Now, by this afternoon, the low is expected to move toward the north or northeast and continue that motion through tomorrow. Now, in 2 days, it's 20% chance. In 5 days, and that's what we're looking at now, 5 days, 20%. This was 30% yesterday. It's dropped down a notch now to 20%. I'll keep my eyes on it and keep everyone posted. Okay, everybody's saying, where's Hurricane Hector? Well, Hurricane Hector now has traveled west of 140 west, okay? So now it's not in the eastern Pacific and not on the regular hurricane information you get from the National Hurricane Center. Now to find Hector, we have to go to the Central Pacific Hurricane Center. So I'll get to Hector in just one moment. While we are here, we will check out. Here is Eliana. Yeah, and Eliana has 65 mile per hour winds, barometric pressure 998 millibars, located 15.2 north, 100.3 west, and is moving northwest at 17 miles per hour. Tropical Storm John's got 60 mile per hour winds, minimum central pressure 999 millibars. It's located 15.1 north, 107.3 west, and it is moving west-northwest around 8 miles per hour. Now, disturbance number one is this elongated area of low pressure. It's about 950 miles southwest of the southern tip of the Baja California Peninsula. Now, it's producing a large area of disorganized showers and thunderstorms. Environmental conditions still do appear conducive for development, and a tropical depression is likely to form by the middle of the week, while this system is also moving west-northwestward at around 10 miles per hour. 2 days formation chance, 60%. 5 days, 80%. Now, I know a lot of you guys, this is like yesterday morning. This is the latest that's come in because we're way ahead of them, okay? But the Hurricane Hector situation in the synopsis, according to what they've got here, is going to cross into the local region from Tuesday night into Thursday, though it remains too early to determine precise impacts on island weather at this time. Hector will likely clear the region by Friday with typical summertime trade winds, weather, and that should head right on into next weekend. Now, Hurricane Hector should move into the Central Pacific Basin over the next few hours, which it has now, with the current forecast track keeping the center of Hector just south of the Big Island. However, hurricane impacts extend beyond the center of the low, and the average track arrows of the hurricane thus far are up about 150 miles on either side of the forecast track. Now, Hector will move into the local region around Hawaii from Tuesday night into Thursday, and weather impacts for each island remain highly dependent on the hurricane's intensity and track. Much of the local weather impacts will need to wait until the hurricane gets closer to the islands to forecast, okay? Any kind of slight change in the track over time can produce larger than normal forecast differences. For now, continue to get right for a lot of rain, people. You know, numerous rain showers moving into the eastern side of the Big Island by Wednesday morning as deeper tropical moisture enhances showers along the eastern slopes, okay? Please continue to closely monitor this major hurricane. It's a category 4 this morning as it moves closer to the state. Make sure if you're over in Hawaii, tune into your favorite TV or radio stations, or go online, whatever, you know, that the local meteorologists are doing over there to make sure you're aware of what's going on. The National Weather Service is encouraging everyone to review their hurricane preparedness plans. A guide for hurricane preparedness, it can be found at weather.gov. You guys know this. You're already going through so much over there. And the state of Hawaii and each county also have preparedness information specific to the islands. So please keep this in mind and go ahead and get ready. You will get some effects. Maybe you won't get the full brunt of it, but you will get some effects from Hurricane Hector. We do have a hurricane warning, but this is for the offshore waters around Hawaii. Hurricane warning, Hawaii offshore waters beyond 40 nautical miles out to 240 nautical miles. This is all out in the offshore waters for the hurricane warning as of now. And you can see the convergence zone where it's crossed over now, and the National Weather Service is no longer showing it, but I do have this from 105 this morning. Here we go. Let's make this a little bigger so you can see it. All right, it is a category 4. Hector is a 4. The winds are 140 miles per hour. The pressure is 947 millibars. It's located at 14.9 north, 140.6 west. Hector is moving fairly fast, so that's a good thing. It's moving west at 15 miles per hour. As we take a look at Hector on the European model, this is Tuesday around 10 p.m. right in this area, bringing in all of the backlash of the water over to the islands. You guys can expect beach erosion. You can expect an awful lot of rain, okay? once it does arrive. So we're going to move up to around 4 a.m. Wednesday. You can see it beginning to get a little closer to Hawaii around 10 a.m. Wednesday. Here it is right here. We'll check the winds out in just a moment. And 4 p.m. Wednesday, there you have it. What is the sustained winds looking like at this time? Right in this area, right up in here, 25 miles per hour out of the northeast. That's not too bad. Let's hope and pray it stays on the track and stays far enough out it doesn't do too much damage to the islands. Now, the wind gust, I'm sure that's another story. As you can see, they will be hitting parts of the Big Island and other little islands up around Honolulu. But what is this reading right here? That's 39 miles per hour. But as we get down, it should be a category 3, hopefully, by the time it gets here. There's wind gust of 112. We'll have to wait and see. And by the time it gets past Hawaii, it should be a category 2, just start to diminish. So let's go back to the rain. This should be affecting Hawaii through Thursday. We'll move up to 10 p.m. Wednesday night when it's right underneath the Big Island. What is the sustained winds like? Here it is right here. Not doing too awfully bad on the Big Island or the other islands. Looking like, well, that's around, let's see, 5 miles per hour. That's not bad at all. But that doesn't mean things can't change, people. Things can't, it can change. So we'll go up to around 4 a.m. Thursday morning, and it is starting to track on away from Hawaii now. What about the rain? We'll check that out right quick. You can see most of that is also staying south at this time. And we'll go up to 12 p.m. for Thursday. Should be well out of the way now, just rain showers off and on all of the islands around Hawaii. However, all of this could change. But this is the latest update on what's going on with Hector and all the other systems out in the Pacific, as well as our little 97L that we have in the Atlantic. I hope each of you have a great day, a safe day, and everyone in Hawaii, please go ahead and make sure you're prepared in case Hector jogs a little the other way, then you're going to get a much more severe effect from this. It could be bad enough as it is anyway, but please prepare, okay? If it doesn't happen, whoopee, that's great. All the other systems that have come off the coast, they should miss land as of now, the way it's looking. They're just going to intensify, have lots of rain, wind, and get caught up in other systems and move on out and away or disintegrate at this time. Who knows? By the time I check again, it could be all different. Everybody stay safe. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Everything you do for me. Peace, love, and kindness to all.